Welcome to training on using the brief assessment template in behavioral health. This training is for NextGen 5.9, 8.4. Thank you for your attention. Let's get started. Here the patient chart is already open. The 4-point check has been completed to verify the right location, right provider, right patient and the right encounter date. We will spend the next few minutes looking at the brief assessment template as well as a couple of other NextGen features. Navigating the comprehensive assessment takes too many clicks. The brief assessment template replaces the 5 long templates that make up the comprehensive assessment. Hover over the navigation bar to access the brief assessment template. The left navigation bar will be your new best friend. Find brief assessment on the list and select. The brief assessment template has 10 panels. We will quickly review the panels together. You will find that the documentation process is very much the same. Starting at the top is the general panel. The general panel is where you can start a new intake, enter the program name, or enter start and end times for billing. Selecting the new intake button will clear all data, except for histories, trauma, and risk assessment. The next panel is the presenting concerns. This is free form text. You are also able to use my phrases. For VCC, many providers choose to document presenting concerns on the intake tab, and then return to the assessment template. Next is histories. Review different types of history by clicking in the left column. Whatever the arrow points to, should show in the grid on the right. To add history, click the Add button located at the bottom of the history grid. Notice there is also a link for confidential history. A new link for social determinants of health can also be accessed here. Be sure to view the training on social determinants of health for more information. The Substance Use and Addictive Behavior panel provides just an overview. Alcohol and tobacco carry over from other templates. To view or add more details, click on the blue links provided, to document substance use or tobacco usage. This is the substance abuse pop-up. Open any of the panels needed to document information for the patient. The trauma history panel gives a place to document current or prior abuse of any kind. It is easy to click on none reported, at the top, but, if the patient reports abuse, document using the fields provided, including any details. Be sure to follow any mandated reporting requirements for the state of California. The Mental Status Evaluation panel has a place for free form text. The Mental Status Exam link opens a pop-up template to use instead of the written narrative. This is the Mental Exam pop-up. Open each of the panels to document information for the patient. Next, we have the Risk Assessment panel. At the top, there is a link to the Suicidal, Homicidal Risk pop-up template. This is a meaningful use measure. It is also located under Screening Tools. You can easily document on this panel if the patient is not currently a danger to self, others, or property. It has a place to document past and current data on suicidal ideation and/or attempts, homicidal tendencies or destruction of property. Click on Add, the data will show in the grid below. Repeat the process to document other events as applicable. A free text field to enter a safety management plan is also available just below the grid. The assessment diagnosis panel has a link in the upper right corner for the DSM-5 documentation. Once the diagnosis has been added, status, severity, impressions and DSM specifiers can be added. My phrases are available for specifiers, if you find them helpful. Click on Add to Grid. The treatment plan panel is for exactly that. Add new goals, objectives and intervention in the space provided. A link to the IAP is provided if it requires updating based on the goal section. Be sure to click Add to Grid. Once the goals have been addressed, the next part of the treatment plan panel is to add plan instructions. Click on the button titled Add Plan Instructions. A diagnosis is required in order to add plan instructions. Highlight the diagnosis. Click on any instructions related to that diagnosis. Here I have selected some instructions for my patient. Notice the diagnosis is added next to that instruction. When you are done, click on Place Order. You may get a task recipient pop-up. Select Who Task, or just click on OK if you want to task yourself. Repeat this process for any additional diagnoses and save and close. Any plan instructions added in this way will show in the plan grid. Below the grid there is space to free type additional plan information. My phrases are available. Next is the signatures panel. This does not take the place of legal signatures. Use the electronic keypad to add appropriate signatures. A task button is available to make a request for signature. For example, if a supervisor needs to review the documentation, the last panel is the behavioral health billing section. Start and end times share from the times in the general panel. Check the service performed by box. Your name, as well as the time and date will be automatically entered. Then, click in the service description field and select the service from the pop-up list. Finalize the visit by submitting the billing codes and generating documents. The Generalized Anxiety Disorder Instrument is now available on the Screening Tools template. Screening tools can be found on the left navigation bar, as well as other places in NextGen. Click on the G87 link to open the assessment document. The 7 questions. The total score and interpretation will calculate automatically. Be sure to save and close. The screening will now show in the screening tool grid. Other assessments can be entered manually and will also be added to the grid. The instrument used should also be scanned into the patient chart. Remember to save and close. Thank you for completing this training. This video will be available in Policy Tech for future reference. You should now be familiar with the panels on the brief assessment template in behavioral health. Be sure to submit a help desk ticket if you have questions on the training you just completed.